Hello. Just thought I'd record my Guild War attacks and give my thought process on what I do. Maybe it's helpful to somebody, perhaps? I don't know. to start off, I generally think about what I don't want to have happen to me. So I don't want Rimuru in round one here. I don't want him to one-shot any of my other units. So the easiest answer to that is because he's grass, he'll target water. That's basic game mechanics, right? And in order for a crowd not die to that, which he may probably won't, but it'd be a lot safer if we put Proof of Valor on him. Just so, you know, he gets that little bit of extra survivability. It's honestly probably not necessary since Rimuru doesn't have anything buffing him here. We could also do Adamant Shield, and that'll give our team a little bit of bulk as well. And then we want to kill the Arabi. That's pretty important. Arabi, if you leave her up, she'll just kill your stuff slowly. When I see an Aravi, a Neuron activates, and I want to slam LQC into her. It's not necessary here, though, I don't think. I feel like we're just... If we bring in Landy, and then... That should be sufficient for dealing with their whole team, because Landy will be the fastest unit here, so Rimuru will target her. And then he'll target Crow then, right? So we're just thinking what happens when we go into the battle, right? So Rimuru steal buffs, give them to the team. That's honestly a positive for us. And then he'll also, since our crowd doesn't have any buffs, he won't defense break us, which would be a concern. On our Landy, I'm going to actually, Guiding Light's not necessary for this. It's not going to do anything. So I'm just going to toss Bloodstone on, just to, you know, this. I mean, you could put Symbol, but in round two here, we're going to be using Zahak to deal with these guys, and he's got the Symbol, so yeah, that's kind of just, you know, just a little bit of bulkiness. It'll probably actually be relevant, right? So you've got Landy and Crow. Landy's just gonna DPS everything, and everything's going to die, most likely. So we've got a slot open, and in this case, we can either bring something that, you know, one-shots the Aravi, right, so she's not a threat. We can bring something that heals us, so that we just tank it all and win. Or we can just bring... Well, I guess those are probably the only options, honestly, here. I guess one thing is, like, you could bring Agras on Arius, right? That would make Crow not die. But, so, we do need to deal with the Aravi, though, in one way or another. Being, do we tank her, or do we just kill her, right? So that's a question that needs to be answered. I'm probably just going to tank her with Ruel. My Ruel's pretty... I mean, she won't die to a Ravi, okay? Well, I mean, she probably won't. Not if we have Adamant, that's for sure. Not next, don't worry. Gear's kind of scuffed too, don't worry about that either. Right? So Ruel allows us to have just... I mean, she's just safe. Another option here would be Doris. She's also good, obviously, but I'm going to use her round two here. So actually looking at round two, right, we've got two people that evade, which sounds kind of scary, but Smilegate gave us Wanda and Zahak, and so now your evasions are futile. So we need to consider which one we're killing first. Because Crow is here, we don't actually Well, I don't have anything that can really tank the Violet for very long, right? I could bring Amelia, though. But wait, which could tank a hit, but you're going to be killing the Violet first and then tanking the two dark units, right? So we're going to use Amelia to push our Zahawk up, give him an attack buff, right? There's no way we get outsped by the FC. Well, I mean, there is way. This isn't, I don't have this scouted, right? So it could be like a 250 speed FCC, but that is actually not that bad for us. You know, we just S1 the Violet. No skill, no file anymore. Who'd have thought? And then we want something to tank the two dark units so they're not hitting our stuff. So we just bring out the Doris and then Kablam. If their Violet is cracked enough to kill Doris, it was lost before it even began, most likely. So this team, it should work, right? So we S3 the Violet, right? Pretty straightforward. And then we just S1, well, we push our Zahawk up using Amelia. We kill the Violet in one hit. Assuming he's not absurdly tanky, this should be enough to kill most Violets, right? Like, if it's a 30k plus FCC plus a really tanky Violet, he will survive, which would give credence to killing the Rylet first, because, like, there's no way you can make a Rylet tanky enough, right? You can get away with putting a Violet at base speed and, you know, just having him counter for the CR push, so it's more likely that he's on that type of build here. But even, I didn't prepare to share the damage calc screen, but like, even if he's got like, 1000 defense, right? The 30k HP FCC, he'd need, around, actually, it's not too unreasonable that he survives this, but my Zahawk will deal 21k damage, roughly, with his S3 onto the Violet here, which has to get through Arius and the barrier. So maybe I should rethink what I'm doing here to have something that kills the Rylet first and tanks the Violet. That might be something like, for example, bringing... Well, who else could tank a Violet, right? Because the main unit that comes to mind when I think, all right, I'm going to tank this Violet is Crow. I believe because, you know, he's forced to attack them, right? However, if we're not doing that, and we're killing the Rylet for us, we no longer need Doris. So you can bring other stuff. But what is other stuff that sufficiently does what we want to do here? You can just bring an LQC. Wait, that's a valid strat. No cap. Nah, I think we're okay. Like, I'm just gonna assume my Zahawk is cracked enough to kill a Violet through FCC barrier and Arius with attack buff and penetration. I guess the other option would be to bring C. Lilius, right? But, I mean, C. Lilius is a ML5, you know, and, but yeah, it'd be for the vigor buff to give even more attack, right? So we go from like 21k to 25k on his S3, so it's pretty substantial, and you're definitely not tanking that, at least. But then we'd be dealing with the Rylet attacking our C. Lilius, which we don't want the Rylet to be attacking our C. Lilius, and it would also cause the FCC to die faster, which we don't particularly want the FCC to die faster. We need to stall enough to S3 the Rylet with our Zahawk. So we need to, you know, we need to S1 the FCC a couple times. I think this will work, though, most likely. Even if it doesn't kill the Violet, we'll be able to, like, cycle around and S1 him again. It's a hawk. No, it'll work out. So we're going in with this. Things that can go wrong, though, right? So the Aravi can fuck us up, right? We're not concerned about Rimuru doing anything to us particularly, you know? Rimuru is only going to help us, honestly. He's going to let us crow something early on. We're likely going to crow the Bellion just so she's out of the picture. But Aravi counters are kind of scary. It should be okay, though. Like, so long. That'll just be okay. There's no, nothing really more to it. Yep. Alright, we go in with this, and hopefully I don't int live to nobody. Well, it's not live, but you get what I mean. So, we take a screenshot, you know, we're gonna post this on Discord for the guild, it'll help them with their attacks. Their rumor is kinda fast. We S3 with landing. Shocking, I know. He's on symbol. So he's trying to kill your stuff, but... Oh right, I forgot about that meme. That I give my stuff units, my stuff buffs. Alright, so we're missing roughly 13k HP, so I'll get a pretty fat force here on the Bellion. I don't think it'll kill her, but you know. She'll die on her turn most likely. And one thing we're going to do is heal our Landy, because that defense break kinda spooky. We could give defense buff to ourselves, but I don't think we need it to tank this. Alright, heal Landy. And then put their Aravi to shame. Nice unit. Okay, she got heal. Isn't that annoying, honestly? Oh, that's high effectiveness. What the fuck? Alright, so we're just S2-ing here. Push her back. It was an injury Bellion. Which is okay. Okay, she didn't proc, which is good for us. We're not worried about getting injured too hard, though. Oh, he got crit resist buff. Alright. So Bellion's dead, so we're not really scared of much now. Right, you just S1 things till they die. But that was really high effectiveness on the Bellion, though. I'm surprised the reroll got focused. She rolled the what's its face buff. Alright, so we're going to I kinda wanna S3 myself here, but I'm gonna S3. Play S3 crowd here. I think we should probably just to get it off cooldown. Well, I might need it though, because I don't have my S2 max to mull up. Hehe. because crowd can just take a hit a turn. No. S1. S1's the play. Listen. Oh shit. S1 might not have been the play. S1 was the play. Alright, so Aravi, she has S3 next turn, so we're not worried about that yet. I will have defense buff for that as well. Okay, we just heal ourselves, and alternatively, we heal the crow. And then S3 ourselves, so then the crowd tanks the... Nah, we just heal ourselves. We might S3 ourselves next turn though, just so that Aravi won't hit us. Okay. I doubt this is our concern. Because we will have defense buff. Probably. I say probably, because Ruel might take two turns, but... Do we S3 sell? I mean, she does have S3, but she's also going to die to Lindy most likely. But if we do S3 ourselves... Well, Crown's also got Force. Yeah, we S3 ourselves, but only so that we don't hit the A-Rabby and push her forward. So our Crow has speed buff from Landy, right? So she'll end up... I mean, Crow will end up getting hit, but I guess we overthought it, because, you know, Landy S1 does in fact do damage. So here's the one that was kind of sketch, I guess. So we push... It's not base speed Violet, that's good to know. But wait, let me just post this in Discord really quick. I think this was bought for it. Bought R1. Actually. Dot. Okay. Right, I'll put the speed counts in anyway, later. So we push our Zahawk, and then give an attack buff, you know how it goes. Okay, and then we decided to kill Violet, right, beforehand. And hopefully it does kill. Yes, that was plenty. So he's very low defense. Wait, why do I have English audio? Kinda cringe. So this Rylet kinda hurts. Psych. No. We've got a pretty weak Doris. Only like 1.7k defense. So we'll just S3 here, because why not? They'll push. Pushing Zahawk is basically decreasing his cooldowns, right? If you want to look at it like that. We'll get the skill nully off with this. Well, this skill nully. Oh, dual attack, naturally. We actually S2 ourselves here, though. Just because decreasing cooldowns, like I said earlier. Oh. I don't actually know what it does. I think it gives them a barrier, okay. We resist? That's good to know, right? Because it could be a high effectiveness or something on the FCC. I don't think that it'd mess us up too much, though. Alright, so next turn we'll have S3. And by next turn, I mean pretty soon here, actually. Because we're going to push him with our Doris. What the fuck? Did I put Unity set on? God damn. But no. You go here. And then this guy dies. Oh, it wasn't even Arius on the FCC. Wait, was it not? I don't know. Shit. Oh, I wasn't paying attention to their HPs. Why? Oh, we're recording though, ah! No. Okay. And, yeah, this is a pretty weak defense though, you know? Like, not necessarily stat lines, just unit choice on their end. So there wasn't like any advanced thinking going on, you know? Fuck, this is 20 minutes? Nobody's gonna watch this. Oh well. Yep, I'll make another recording for just each of my attacks here today, probably. Alright, this is their mid fort for this war. It wouldn't sound good. There we go. Classic. Round one looks kinda. It either is or isn't AIDS, I'm not sure. Like, it looks annoying, but it might not be annoying. See, Lilius is just, by default, an annoying unit, though, so we're going to assume it's annoying. This one would be pretty easy if we had Operator Secret, actually. Because I feel like a lot of people forget that See, Lilius, I think it's her S2, gives the highest HP unit a barrier. Right, and then you can just op sig it down, and then you can kill the other thingy. It looks pretty annoying, though, but we're gonna bring LQC. I kind of wanted to stay away from bringing a bunch of ML5 in for this showcase-type thing, but, you know, they've got... This guy's got 5 ML5 whipped out on the board. You know? It's like, he's got ML pen on defense, though. There's gotta be some prank involved with that, right? Like, it's probably hyperspeed or... Wait, hyperspeed ML pen? Maybe. Wait, imagine this. Okay, so the ML pen, S3s, us hyperspeed, and the defense breaks us, and then this guy, he kills all our stuff. A survival option. No, I think he's just there to... try to make you bring Landy, perhaps? And then the Ricky kills your Landy or something? I don't know. So what do we bring through? Let's do this one at a time. So, one way to deal with this type of team, right, is you bring a dark unit. Right, you need a dark unit to not have your stuff get fucked, right? So, one viable comp here would be Emilia. Operator Cigarette, right? She would be the dark unit. We do not own her, as I think I said already. So we're just gonna bring just probably a Ravi. You know, my a Ravi is better than your a Ravi copium. No, so here it's kind of sketchy, right? But a Ravi is just able to tank this stuff, you know. Do you go proof for this? I like the Draco plate. Oh wait, no, Draco plate does nothing, I'm stupid. I go -25k. Where do I go? I guess Merit Soul Slot. Just something that gives us damage, right? Sure. Because we have LQC on our team, so that's crit damage reduction. Alright, so I am actually concerned that we won't have enough to kill one of their units, right? So we're going to go and we're going to yoink this Warhorn, a good artifact. We're going to toss that on Emilia. Oh, where'd she go? She's not a warrior, right? How could I forget? Alright, so now we've got a little bit more attack on our LQC. Our LQC is pretty powerful. And we'll have 3 stacks of Hellcutter. Technically, we need more than that for 100% crit rating, right? Because it'll be at 80. And plus 15, so it's 95. Yeah, this is good enough. You know, that's basically 100%. Crit rate. Well, I mean, I don't know. Something's going ahead of our other things. Anyways, so that'll probably work round one. Because even if the LQC doesn't kill the Archdemon here, a Ravi will just be there following up, you know, and she should be able to finish her off, even with attack down, because she's got HP scaling. So that's that, and then there's this. See, I really don't like defenses like this, because it's like, you don't see ML Ken on defense. Who the fuck puts ML Ken in a fort? What am I supposed to do? Huh? My brain's not wired to deal with this. We probably just bring, what's her face? She's this unit, Spectre Tenebria. I'm kind of concerned that this guy... Killer? I don't think that'll happen. We want to give him somewhere to attack, you know, something that baits. Ideally something that has some ER as well. Because he does reset cooldowns. So, The grass units we have available to us that do that are... well, the first one that comes to mind is Rowana, I guess? Like, she's just a sack of meat for the most part. And then what would you bring for our last unit? Just another Soul Weaver, I guess? Or something... No, we want something that can knock him out of stealth, actually. What can be that? Well, I kind of want to bring Seaside. Belonne? You know? not sure how good that is here, though. Because that'll break the... Think, brain power. Do I have enough IQ for this? I could also bring two water units. Like, Crow and something. Yeah, that'd be sufficient. Like, if I just bring Crow and Montmorency... Crow on Arius this time. Great. Let's give him a fat Arius, you know how it goes. Blame it, -5k. Alright. Like, that'll get rid of the silence, I guess. But, you know, you're not really scared of getting silenced. Because if he has enough effectiveness to silence us, we aren't at risk of dying to begin with. But not. I haven't used Montmorency in a while. Does she even have an artifact? She do? It's not really necessary for it. She's just tanky enough to tank him. Right? So, what if it's hyper speed, high effectiveness, ML can we win still? Because we have immunity, and then we're not in danger, really. Yeah, this just works. I might put... I'll put Tome over here, though. Just so we can cycle a little bit faster. Yeah. This'll just work, I guess. Maybe? Wait, hold up. This is important. I don't fight either of those units ever. So what does he do? Let's read. Oh, I pulled one of them? Oh, I don't remember doing that. So I know he does this spell first. Right? And then this thing does what? So it gives him attack buff. Right? Before attacking when using this. So we definitely do want some bulk. Penetrates defense by 30%. Is that scary? Like, he doesn't have any reach beyond this for my, what's-her-face, Spectre Tenebria, and will also have defense buff up the majority of the time, unless he resets my cooldowns, which, if he resets my cooldowns, we're not worried about dying, you know, so, I think we're just good on all ends here. Yeah, so he does this. Which probably does nothing. I mean, you can assume he's fast, a little bit fast. But yeah. Then he does this, gives himself attack buff. And. Yeah. Well, I go in. Look, thanks. Here you go. Come swap. Yeah. I can't see it really going that wrong. Honestly, it's ML Ken, right? Oh shit, we lost our comps. What were we doing? We were doing like, this here. I know that wasn't there. It was over here. Aha! There you go, now it's the same. We're just doing double water. I don't know why we're doing double water particularly. It's just because my brain's a little bit frazzled by this defense. And then the only thing that actually makes sense here is the Spectre Tenebria. Like, you can bring whatever the fuck you want into this, I feel. Like, there's no way there's not a prank here, right? Wait, hold up. Okay, no, there's no prank here. It's just garbage. Wait. Yeah, it's just garbage. Okay. I mean, I could bring a Soul Weaver that... Oh yeah, I could just do Ruel instead of Montmorency. That's probably a better idea, honestly. Well... Or Doris, even. No, because Doris's crit damage reduction is only from, isn't it only versus dark units, I'm pretty sure? Yeah, it's only from dark units, so Ruel's probably better here. Okay, I'm gonna go in with this and lose the round 2 and cry. So round 1, it's just Celalise to Celalise things, you know, attacks the dudes with their stuff. And then Emilia pushes LQC. LQC kills, well, probably kills the Archdemon. Because Aravi, listen, this is kind of just assuming we have enough gear to kill that. But yeah, this should be weird. Should be good. Should be. Anyways, I go in. Speed Aravi, not counter attack. Oh, not shit. Oh, wait, we get. Wait, how does this work? Oh, she gets a Hellcutter Stark on her turn. So we have 99 crit chance. I forgot about that. Okay. So we go here. Mid R1. And then a dot. Very cool. Okay. So, alright, here's the test. I don't think this will kill. Dude, it's not... it doesn't have any other mitigation, right? It's not like she's an Arius in here. Our Aravi will get cut by our Emilia, actually. That's pretty good. Anyways. Whoosh! 4 Hellcutters stack. I guess you're in Japanese now, but... She has no Mola. That's good for us, I guess. Pog champion, am I right? Oh god. Okay, yeah, she's gone. Anti-magic mask on the Aravi. Wait, were we actually in danger of dying if the, anti-magic class scrolled crit damage? Perhaps. What the fuck? Okay, this voice actor is actually an everything for everyone, dude. So is this one. Anyways. Unmolded. Archdemon. What do we push? This one. Oh no, we weren't in any danger because we cut her. Yes. I'm a genius. So that didn't do any damage at all. It is base speed ML can't wait. We're gonna take the screenshot next turn. This is just a random tip if you do ever scout things, but like if somebody gets pushed up like that from like Quadra's Origin or something, you don't need to take the screenshot with them. You can just, you know. And go to the next unit whose speed you know. And take it with them. Easy clap. So we have defense buff. Yada yada yada.
Good. Round 2. Enter. period. Placeholder. Yes.
Ah, this is more like it. Okay, so let's see. Is this Elo Hell? Perhaps. Anyways. So does this deal any damage? Not really. Oh! I see what he was going for now. Wait, that's actually interesting, kind of, isn't it? Because... Okay, so I see it now. So if the MLKin were, like, a little bit faster, right? And he went before he got his S3 off, right? Then you'd be defense broken on your DPS, potentially. That's, I mean, Ruel exists, though, so you're good. yeah. Anyways. That guy's dead on his turn. I don't... is it BM if I just don't use my, abilities? I'll use my abilities. Why'd he hit the barrier? This game sucks! Let's kill him. Did I just crown him? Wait, I crowned the FCC here actually. Big brain. Wait, think about it. Because if I crowd the FCC, she'll be the one that gets her barrier. Or she just dies, maybe. Why is her audio English? What? Oh, he's just dead to poison. I'll aim here. Oh. Watch, we're about to lose to MA Ken. He wins these. What? No effectiveness. I mean, this is the safe play. Okay, I thought there was no thought process in there, but... there was thought process in their MLKen defense. Watch, I'm gonna crit. I didn't crit. Cringe. What? Horse? In? Nah, I'll just heal them. I'm pretty sure Steny cuts anyways. Yeah. And then you win. Huh. Was he fast? I don't know. I mean, the winner is me. Anyways, that's that one. I don't know. Did I actually put brain power in there or not? I'm not sure. Anyways. Did anybody lose to that? Okay, well, let's do that. yes, the ultimate counter to MA Ken. Wait. Multiple people brought it in. Goddamn. Anyways, that's the last guild, not us. That is that one. Mm-hmm. On to the next one. Alright, here's the last on the top fort for this war. Maybe I should have, like, an actual introduction type thing. But it's probably not necessary. Anyways. This one? I can't tell if it's scary or not. It's probably scary to some degree. Oh, maybe I should turn this up, you know. Let me get the in-game music up. I don't know, that's fine where it is. Okay. Right. So we want to kill things. We are murder hobos. Oh, excuse me. Except, there's a problem here. They have defense buff. One option is to go at it like this. And then we whip out Amelia. We whip out LQC. Kablam. That's one solution, right? Then the ARV dies. And then we only have this stuff to deal with. Which is actually pretty scary still, because this is our last attack, though, so we don't mind if we lose something to a crowd horse. That's why I saved it for last. And then this bottom one here, though. We want to bring Zahawk in, right? Because we see Violet, we Neuron activates, bring Zahawk. Well, I guess alternatively, Neuron activates, we bring Crow. But we do want something that does go before the Zahawk to proc. Or we want something that revives Zahawk. Right, so either Buell or, I guess, Shooting Star Akades, you know? Phew, wait, where's mine? Yo, I got her molded a little bit here. She has plus 10 ring on. Let's go Reforge Beat, sweet. Anyway, because, I mean, Zahawk does his thing, right? Rimuru will counter him and likely kill, because, you know, it's full damage, no bolt. It's kind of, a thing to consider, essentially. But it's not that big of a deal if he does die. But importantly here, we want a unit that gets... Yeah, we do need something that gets reject provoke, because it's unreasonable to assume that whoever we're using to give... Well, we could do Mediator Kawarik here. Wait, we got distracted. I was working on this one. But do I undistract and work go back to this one, or would it be distracted to go back to this one after working on this one halfway? Interesting. Kawi-rick. Wait, how do you say it? Kawi-rick. Oh, God. Okay, so, wait. So, one option, we bring Crow. And that's it, that solves his whole team, potentially. Wait a minute. Yo, is it? Wait, okay, look. So, I can't, it's been a while. He doesn't have ER though, so he'll just get dispelled, won't he? But I want to... Oh wait, but Mercedes has his ring. Wait, do you have a flat HP ring? With no flat defense? Hold up. Do I whip this out? Oh, I still want to whip this out, actually. It says flat defense on it. Oh my god. I want to whip it out. You don't understand, bro. Oh wait, no. We can't whip it out, because Rimuru. Okay. Crisis averted. Look. You don't get a Terran or Royal Guard people that often in this society. You know, we live in it. Nah, we couldn't kill the Sea Lilius then anyways. I guess we could maybe. Eventually. After long, hard battle. Oh, but I so want to bring Terran. You don't understand. Yeah, I would get it, but yeah, I want to do it though. Like, I really want to. Like, you know, I want to. It's a viable strategy. Don't worry about it. What? Because what would it let us do? It didn't let us rain. Wow, dude, I haven't used Christie in so long. Wait, I think this is the play here. No cap. So we get Christie, and we get... Because even if he steals the buffs, right? Like, even if he steals evasion... Oh, wait, but if he steals evasion buff, that means he has evasion buff, and then the Terranor guard's not getting crit. Right, no, it's this one. Oh, wait, but then I see the Lilius is dual attacking things. But it sounds so fun. Okay. Brings a hawk. Let me hit the violet every time. And then I'm not gonna care about losing the hawk, honestly. We bring Meat Eater Quirik. And then we bring just something that doesn't die immediately to a light breeze. That's our thing. Our requirement. So we just bring Prowl. He still has Arius, right? Yeah. So this will work. Because the Sea Lilius will be through the tech in there, but things will be dead. Probably? What if my things are dead? Is there a way Rimuru does enough damage? Like, if he's full glass cannon. Yeah, we'll just put the proof on our crowd to be safe. Oh, wait, but with Arius. Oh, wait. He steals invisibility, so we can't see him anymore. Oh, we should be good, though. So, wait, assuming... It'll just break out, okay? We do need to put the Warhorn back on. Our Kawarik from earlier. Wait, I got distracted, dude. My brain, it scrambled. Too much Guild Wars, you know. Okay. So this is just to tank that. You'll be invisible. You know, I can't see you. Yeah, nice joke. So what do we bring here? We can immediately kill the Arambi, but then we need something that deals with both Crow and Bellion with this comp, right? Because, Alkisi could, but I don't think that's the comp we want to bring. I think we want to do like we did earlier with like the Crow. Probably, Dude, this is a really good one to just straw man. Or it could be, wait, is this an MLKen solo? Wait, viable strategy? Have I spotted a viable strategy? No. Unfortunate. Alright, so we got this one. We had the brain power for that. Do we have the brain power for this? We can just bring things that kill his things. I don't have straws, as I was saying, though. He'd be good here. Rimuru is good here, too. Wait, I could do this angle, though. I could do Emilia. Sea Lilius. And then LPC solo. I think that works most of the time. Every time. Because think about it, you're not actually... Once the Arabi's gone, you've just got Bellion and Crow attacking you, right? So you're not in too much pressure, right? Like, we'll just phrase it like that. You're not under much pressure from them. Although Crow will horse somebody just straight up immediately after that. And if it's the LQC targets, we lose. So we don't need that. We don't need the Sealist. Sealist is just kind of BM. I'll just put in... Wait. See? I'll just put in Adras because he can do survival things. Yes, sure. Holy Sacrifice. That looks good. We have very stacked Adras. Okay, so we put the Tome back on the Emilia for the cycle-y thingy. Where'd the Tome go? It's on our Montmorency because we put it on her because we were going to use it for a little bit, but then my... I had a moment of clarity. Anyways. Magahara's Tome. Okay, so this'll just work. Probably. It'll definitely work. Anyways, we go in with this. So, here's how this... Wait, let me just see how it's gonna play out. So, Emilia... goes. She pushes a QC. LQC doesn't crit the A-Ravi. So address dual attacks with LQC on the A-Ravi, and then the A-Ravi die. No. I mean, we crit most of the time with our scuff crit chance, you know? You know? And this one, Silenius does hurdling. Blem. Rimmer is likely faster than our Kekvix, and then Warhorn pushes him ahead of Zahawk. And then, you know, Zahawk gets to kill that. But even if he doesn't, like, he can just S2 and then get another turn that way. Well, get ahead in the CR bar that way, I should say. If we do that, though, we need to consider that we don't want to S2 with Crow, because Rimuru will steal that defense buff, and then we can't one-shot the Violet that way. But this probably works, you know. Is there a different fire unit I can bring? Not really. I could bring Mercedes, actually. I think that's more valid than Address, potentially. No, because that's like AoE, and then we risk Elbrus and whatnot. This is fine. Copium. This is fine. So we go in with this. I press go. It was a fast crow. I kind of was scared of that. Excuse me. Okay, screenshot taken. We crit? this is the joy of using low crit rate units. Are we crit? But damn, she's tanky. Yeah, and this is why we brought Address. She rolled effectiveness naturally. It's okay, we'll resist anyways. Oh, we actually resisted. I think S2 is probably the play. Maybe S1 just to try and strip it. Eh. We can do that next turn. Because Crow would have just given it back to her anyways, right? It's injury rebellion as well. Oh, we haven't missed a crit once. We're so good at the game. Wait, she's got... Oh no, my Amelia just doesn't have any... what's its face? Effect resist. Feels bad. Alright, so we're gonna do this, and she's gonna Elbrus. 100%. We are truly skilled. Like, push LQC. Yeah, just because cycling. Not necessarily because she needed it. Al?
Huma!
Oh, yeah. Who's Al? See ya? Horse next turn. Oh, we just kill Crow here. What did he say? Okay. Okay, yes, yes. The CR has played out exactly as I predicted. Haha. 19k HP, Rimuru? Is that supposed to kill anything? No, it's actually not supposed to kill anything. Okay, I'll take the screenshot on the hot stream. Where's my screenshot? What? Hold up, technical difficulties. Can you not? Edit a message? Wait. There we go. Anyways. Be gone. Thought. And then he's invisible. Right? So we're good on that front. I just attack here. It's a tooth? What? Why? What is it supposed to do? I guess I didn't need a horse yet. That's okay. We crit. And then we press the auto button. That was unmolled S1, by the way. I only have S3 mola. Oh wait, this is necessary. Gone. What? Okay. Yeah, pretty clean like that, though. Their Arebi was fairly tanky. I think that was close on us killing or not. Who did butcher in this? Oh, right. He pressed auto. That'll do it. Okay. Well, that's all the forts for this guild war. Am I under attack? I am under attack. But I am far more skilled than them. Okay, well, hopefully these videos aren't too long-winded and me rambling for hours. Wait, actually, I think we're sub 1 hour altogether. That's pretty cool. But hopefully this helps in some way. I don't know. It might have been just more rambly than helpful. Because I think I completely forgot about the point of me recording this at some point and just started talking about nothing, and not saying my thought process too, verbosely, that's a word, yeah, I wasn't too verbose or descriptive in how I was, dealing with things, maybe, I don't know, I'm sure I can receive feedback though, yep. How do I end this? I think I just stopped this button. Yep. Okay. Thanks for watching, I guess.
Don't forget a like.
maybe I'll do more of these though. It wasn't too bad. I'll see how it's received.